Hey everyone, our animated overlay is finally available in the Nerd or Die store. Let me show you how to set it up in just a couple of minutes, and even customize it a bit to your liking. Let's get right into it. Before we get started, if you'd like a completely free version of this design, you can check out the non-animated version, which is available as a pay-what-you-want item in the Nerd or Die store. Anyways, I'll also be doing a giveaway for 5 download codes of this product. Details of how to enter that will be at the end of this video. Let's go ahead and get into how to set this up inside of OBS Studio, and this process will be pretty similar in XSplit as well if you happen to use that. First, after you check out from the store, you'll be presented with multiple download links on the webpage, as well as in your email address that you entered. You can use the product preview images on the website, or open up the preview image that comes with the download to know what each file looks like. Now, just download any of the files that you'd like to use, or of course you can download them all. Once your downloads are all finished, open up OBS Studio and add in a media source. I'm going to click Browse and then I'll find the file that I like to add in. Now, let's make sure to set it to loop and hit OK. Once it's added in, you can resize and reposition the source as needed. Now, I need to add in my webcam, and to do this simply, I'll add a video source with my webcam selected. If you need any help with sources in OBS Studio, make sure to check out my video about it. It will cover everything that you need to know. Next, I'll move my webcam source under the media file so that the webcam overlay is on top. I'll get a rough size and position of my cam, and then I'll hold Alt to crop out the areas that exceed the webcam overlay boundaries. It might take a little bit of finesse, but you should be able to crop it so that the edges of your webcam are hidden. If you have any trouble getting this just right, you can always right-click your webcam source and go to Transform, Edit Transform. And from here, you can click inside the appropriate box in the crop section and use the up and down arrows on your keyboard to make more precise adjustments. You can even adjust the X and Y positions here as well. With the webcam set up, let's move on to the supporter section. The pack comes with variations of different types of supporter sections. Let me first load one of the files that has preset labels on it, and this will be added as another media source. However, let's say that you want to add these labels and have them say something different, or perhaps you don't want to include some of this information on your stream. You can always choose one of the blank versions and add in your own text labels inside of OBS Studio. I'm going to right-click this current support section and then replace it with the file called panel-3-animated.mov. And I'll make sure that we set it up to loop as well. From here, you can size and position as needed. Before you add any text sources, make sure that you have the font Big Noodle Tilting installed on your system. If you don't have this font, I'll make sure the link is in the description below. Now, I'm going to be using this font in this video, but you can always use any font that you'd like, of course. I'll give a label to each section. To do this, I'm going to add in a new text source inside of OBS Studio. I'll put something like latest tip in the text field. After that, I'll select a dark color text that I'll use for the labels, since the text will be on a white background. Next, I'll click select font, and then in the font selection box, I'll find the Big Noodle font. You can also set the font type to regular or italic, whatever you prefer. One quick thing that I want to mention is that it's always better to select a bigger font size than you need. This is because when we go to reposition and scale the text, it will become blurry if we need to scale it up by clicking and dragging in the preview area. In this instance, I'll select 48 for my font size, and then I'll hit OK, and then position the text inside of the label as needed. Now we're going to need a text source that actually displays the name of our supporters. If you don't know how to do this, then I have another video about adding this in, which I'll make sure is linked in the description below. To do this, we want to make sure that read from file is selected inside the properties, and then we pick the text file that has our supporters' names in it. I'll also go back into select font and choose the same font as before, but this time I'll make sure that I set the color to something lighter. Feel free to play around with any of the font colors that you'd like, and you may want to even add an outline or drop shadow here as well. For these panels, we're going to need to right align the text so that everything looks good when the names change. To do this, right-click the text source that we added and go to Transform, Edit Transform. Here, change the positional alignment to top right. Now, we need to position this to where we'd like it. Don't forget that you can use the arrow keys for fine-tuning inside of OBS Studio. If you're having any issues with how to do these steps, I highly recommend checking out my video about sources. It will explain everything in detail. If you prefer left-aligned versions of these media files, You can also right-click the media source and go to Transform Flip Horizontal to mirror this image. This, of course, will only work for the blank supporter sections where you have to add in your own labels. Finally, we can add in the HUD file. It's a very straightforward file, and once it's added in, as a media source, you can position it in the top or bottom. To flip it vertically if needed, you can right-click the source and go to Transform Flip Vertical. I'll go ahead and reset the transform and position mine towards the bottom. This file is sort of like a blank canvas where you can put whatever you'd like in it, or you could just leave it there for an aesthetic value. Perhaps you'd like to add in a social media message, or even use this as your supporters section. Whatever you'd like to do with this, that's really up to you. Now that we've added everything in, I want to take a quick moment and discuss how we can customize these files just a little bit. One of the big advantages of using OBS Studio is that we can add a filter on any source. If you don't know about filters, again, check out my video that talks all about them. Anyways, let's add a color correction filter on the HUD source. For starters, we can do something like adding a high amount of contrast in the filter to make the overlay appear a bit brighter against the gameplay. I could also select a color here and change the appearance to match my branding. Let's say you play a lot of Reaper in Overwatch and you want to make your overlay look like dark smoke. You could choose a dark purple or really any type of color and play around with the contrast and brightness to get a cool effect out of these files, and then make them unique to your own stream. I'll go ahead and just play around with the settings here while I talk a little bit about the giveaway. I'll be doing free downloads for this overlay package to 5 random people that retweet the tweet in the description below. The last code will be given out June 13th, 2016, and if you already purchased the package and you win, I'll just simply send you a refund. Anyways, I hope you guys really like this design. Myself and Chris worked pretty hard to get this perfect, and we worked on a lot of small details about it. We also wanted to make sure that we put it at as low a price as possible, so purchasing this really helps support us in making new free resources in the future. Don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful, and subscribe if you'd like to see more great streaming and video game related content from Nerd or Die. Thanks for watching.